Thank you for listening into this webinar entitled What Works Clearinghouse Practice Guides, Evidence-Based Instructional Practices for In-Person and Remote Learning Settings. My name is Betsy Keating. I'm a researcher at Mathematica, and I'm also a What Works Clearinghouse reviewer. In that role, I've worked on the development of 4 practice guides. On today's webinar, we will show how What Works Clearinghouse, or WWC, and its resources can help educators integrate evidence-based practices into their classrooms and schools when in a remote or hybrid learning environment. WWC resources like practice guides remain relevant even as the COVID-19 pandemic has changed the way instruction is delivered. In this webinar, we will first provide an overview of the WWC practice guides, one of the WWC's most widely used publications. Next, we will walk through 2 examples of practice guide recommendations to help you get a better sense of what type of information is included in practice guides. Finally, we will illustrate how the evidence-based practices found in the practice guides can be used in a remote learning instruction setting. Let's begin with our overview of the WWC and its practice guides. The What Works Clearinghouse is an investment of the Institute of Education Sciences, or IES, at the U.S. Department of Education. The WWC's mission is to be the central and trusted source of scientific evidence of what works in education. The WWC conducts systematic reviews to identify rigorous research using a consistent, transparent set of standards. From those reviews, the WWC provides educators with information on evidence that they can use to make decisions. The WWC puts out several products to share findings of what works in education with educators, including intervention reports, which focus on a specific intervention such as fraction face-off or intelligent tutoring for structure strategy, as well as practice guides, which we will be discussing in more detail on this webinar. This slide pictures the WWC website homepage, which can be found at the link at the bottom of the slide. The WWC has released more than 2 dozen practice guides on the WWC website. These are free resources that anyone can download. The goal of the WWC practice guides is to provide educators with evidence-based, actionable recommendations that can help teachers, administrators, and other educators address specific challenges. The recommendations are intended to be implemented in schools by educators at little to no cost. Each practice guide is developed by a panel of experts in the particular field, including educators, researchers, and other practitioners. They combine their knowledge with rigorous research findings to develop the guide and its recommendations. Each guide covers a specific target population. Across the guides, they cover early childhood to post-secondary education. Looking specifically at practice guides for educators in early childhood through grade 12, the guides cover a range of topics, including math, literacy, writing, behavior, dropout prevention, and more general support for students across content areas. That last bullet covers topics like structuring out-of-school time to improve academic achievement and using student achievement data to support instructional decision-making. Each practice guide provides several recommendations on a particular topic, such as teaching elementary school students to be effective writers or reducing problem behaviors in elementary school classrooms. Here we list the 6 practice guides specifically related to math subjects as an example of the types of guides covered within a particular content area. These guides are for educators of students ranging from preschool through grade 12, with multiple guides focusing on elementary school students specifically. The guides address particular subjects like algebra, mathematical problem solving, fractions, and helping students struggling with mathematics classes. Here's what to expect when you open a practice guide. Each practice guide includes several recommendations for educators, typically about 4 to 5 recommendations per practice guide. For each recommendation, the guide will provide specific action steps that help educators carry out the recommendation. Practice guides provide a rich set of examples of how to carry out the action steps. Because providing high-quality instruction always comes with challenges, the guide describes potential obstacles that educators may face when trying to carry out the recommendation, along with advice from the panel on how to overcome those obstacles. Each recommendation is also assigned a level of evidence, either strong, moderate, or minimal. This is based on the strength and quantity of evidence found in studies that the WWC reviewed that support the recommendation. The WWC systematically reviews research on the practices against its evidence standards to assess the level of evidence for each recommendation. Strong evidence means that there is consistent evidence that the practices improve outcomes for a diverse population of students in studies that meet WWC evidence standards. Moderate evidence means that there is some evidence that the practices improve student outcomes in studies that meet WWC evidence standards, but there may be ambiguity about whether the improvement is the direct result of the practices or whether the findings can be replicated with a diverse population of students. Finally, minimal evidence means that the available research may not meet WWC evidence standards, or that the practices may not consistently improve student outcomes. However, minimal evidence does not necessarily mean that the practices are ineffective. For example, one reason a recommendation may have minimal evidence is because the practices are new and have not yet been rigorously tested. Even though the available research on a practice with minimal evidence may provide weaker evidence for those recommendations, the WWC's panel of experts still recommends the practice based on their knowledge and experience. As a practical matter, minimal evidence means that educators might proceed more cautiously, but the WWC has determined that available evidence does not include any warning signs, and experts have confidence in the potential of the practice to be effective. To give you a more concrete sense of what is in practice guides, this slide walks through one specific recommendation from the Foundational Skills to Support Reading for Understanding in Kindergarten through Third Grade practice guide. This recommendation states, teach students to decode words, analyze word parts, and write and recognize words. The level of evidence supporting this recommendation is strong. The practice guide has 6 steps to carry out the recommendations, which are listed on this slide. Each step has at least one example to support educators in carrying out the practice. The star words example, shown at the top right portion of this slide, is for carrying out the 5th action step, namely, teach regular and irregular high-frequency words so that students can recognize them efficiently. This activity includes the use of note cards to help carry out this action step. The recommendation concludes with 2 potential obstacles and solutions. For instance, one potential obstacle is that students may identify the sounds correctly but have trouble arriving at the correct pronunciation. The guide includes the panel's expert advice on how to tackle this obstacle to carrying out the recommendation, including encouraging students to try out different vowel pronunciation until they arrive at a recognizable word. As another example of the types of information found in practice guides, this slide walks through one specific recommendation from the Teaching Strategies for Improving Algebra Knowledge in Middle and High School Students practice guide. This recommendation states, teach students to intentionally choose from alternative algebraic strategies when solving problems. The level of evidence supporting this recommendation is moderate. The practice guide has 3 steps to carrying out this recommendation, which are listed on this slide. Each step has at least one example to support educators in carrying out the practice. In here, you see an example that shows different strategies that can be used to solve linear systems of equations. This recommendation also concludes with 2 potential obstacles and solutions. For instance, one obstacle comes from an educator of students with disabilities who says that my special education students need a very structured process for solving algebra problems. Introducing multiple strategies and asking students to choose among strategies might be hard on them. The guide includes the panel's expert advice on how to tackle this obstacle to carrying out the recommendation, including using explicit instruction on multiple strategies and their underlying rationale to help special education students better understand how different strategies can be useful. Outside of the guides themselves, the WWC website also includes a range of supplemental resources from the practice guides for educators. The supplemental resources draw on the same evidence and panel expertise as the practice guides, but packages information in new ways that may be particularly useful for educators or others, like parents and caregivers. The goal of these supplemental materials is to provide actionable, short resources for educators in addition to the longer resources of the practice guides themselves, recognizing the many demands on educators' time and their need for reliable information. One of these resources is Instructional Tips for Educators. Instructional Tips highlight a few of the recommended practices in more detail for educators. Each practice has a few tips with actionable steps for educators to take. These provide specific examples, including in some cases sample conversations between teachers and students. In addition, the WWC has tips for parents and caregivers. The tips cover several practices that parents and caregivers can implement at home to improve their child's reading skills. Each practice has step-by-step instructions that can be carried out with materials readily available at home. These are formatted as 4 one-pagers that could be printed and sent home as handouts to parents. In addition to the tips for educators and parents, the WWC has summaries of each practice guide. These are typically 8 pages long and include an overview of the recommendations and action steps from the full guide. Finally, the WWC has created several 1 or 2 page infographics that summarize information from the practice guides. The infographics aim to quickly provide educators with key information on topics of particular interest. These can cover multiple practice guides, which differs from the tips and practice guide summaries, which typically just focus on one guide. For instance, the WWC recently released 2 infographics on how to use the evidence-based practices in practice guides to meet the Every Student Succeed Act evidence tiers. Now we would like to turn to how the practice guides and other WWC resources can be used to support implementing evidence-based practices in remote learning settings. Right now, many educators across the country face an unprecedented situation with many schools using remote learning during the COVID-19 pandemic. Despite the challenges of this time, educators still have a need for evidence-based practices and support in implementing them. The WWC has created some resources to help educators identify ways to tailor evidence-based practices from practice guides for a remote learning setting. Specifically, the WWC has 5 new infographics to support educators with remote instruction. The practice guides were originally written with an in-person setting in mind, so these infographics help educators think through how the practice guide recommendations can be carried out in a remote setting. The 5 topics covered in these infographics are reading instruction in elementary grades, writing instruction in elementary grades, writing instruction in secondary grades, math instruction in elementary grades, and math instruction in secondary grades. Each infographic includes examples from 2 or 3 relevant practice guides. The examples show how a practice can be modified to be conducted virtually, using remote whiteboards, presentation slides, physical objects shown over video, and so on. Many other practices from the guides can be implemented remotely, not just those highlighted in the infographics. The infographics are intended to provide illustrative examples of how the practices can be adjusted, but are not intended to provide an exhaustive list of all practices that can be used in a remote setting. Educators may see additional ways to use the practice guide's recommendations in their remote learning classrooms using whatever materials or technology they have available to them. Here's one example from the remote reading instruction in elementary grades infographic. This example comes from the Foundational Skills to Support Reading for Understanding in Kindergarten through 3rd Grade Practice Guide. The practice guide recommends that educators help students develop awareness of segments of sound and speech and how they link to letters by teaching students letter-sound relationships after students have learned to isolate phonemes in speech. By phonemes, we mean the smallest units of sounds in a word. In this example from the full practice guide on how to help students link segments of sound to letters, the focus is on the letter P. The guide recommends the teachers first name the letter and show students a visual version of the letter, both in upper and lower case. Then teachers can show a memorable picture of a familiar word with the phoneme. For each picture, teachers can tell a story that incorporates the corresponding sound of the letter so that students remember the character and sound when they see the letter in print. One simple way to adapt this recommended practice to the remote setting, such as during a lesson conducted over a video conferencing application, is for the teacher to hold up a picture to the camera or share electronic slides with images. This slide has a second example from the infographics, this one from the remote writing instruction in the secondary grades infographic. The example shown here is adapted from the Teaching Secondary Students to Write Effectively practice guide. This recommendation states, help students internalize the features of effective writing by explicitly teaching appropriate writing strategies using the model, practice, reflect process. This process, as noted in the figure here, starts with the model, or I do, where teachers model their writing or strategy use. Then the class moves to practice, which is the we do stage, where students practice writing with a teacher or a peer. Finally, reflect, or you do, entails students evaluating their writing and strategy use. The full practice guide discusses a number of different writing strategies that can be taught using the model, practice, reflect process. In the example shown here, the writing strategy is using a plot diagram or a Freytag pyramid. In a remote setting, teachers can model the diagram in a full class video instruction session and explain each section as part of the I do stage. Then, for the we do stage, teachers can use a digital whiteboard to complete the diagram together with the class based on a novel that the class has read together. If a digital whiteboard is not available, the teacher could create a slideshow where each slide labels another section of the diagram. After that, teachers can ask students to fill out the diagram themselves before writing as part of the you do stage. Teachers can then ask students to reflect on using this strategy in a later class. Check out the infographics for many more examples and ideas for remote math, reading, and writing instruction. That concludes the content of this webinar. This slide includes helpful links to the WWC website, including the homepage, the landing page for the full library of practice guides, and the link to each of the 5 new infographics on remote instruction. Thank you for attending this webinar and for your interest in the WWC practice guides. If you have any questions about the WWC, the practice guides, or any other WWC products, please reach out to the WWC Help Desk through the WWC website, which is linked on this slide as well. This webinar and related resources will be available online at the WWC website for future reference. Thank you.